Good morning, my name is Dr H. I am here today just chatting a little bit more about acne scarring. That's what we do treat all the time. Today we have Phoebe, and I just wanted to talk to you a little bit about what our plan was with Phoebe so you can understand the rationale behind the procedures that we performed to treat this. So Phoebe came to see me a few weeks ago, all the way from Liverpool, is that right? Okay. And she has a pattern of scarring. If you look closer here, just zoom in for me, Chantal. She has what we call rolling scars. And not only rolling scars, but these rolling scars are tethered as well. So this is the main scar type that Phoebe has, and is one of the most common scar types that occur in people with acne scarring. So the problem here is that most people use generic ways of treating acne scarring. They'll say, let's just roll needles over it, because that's what we do for any type of acne scarring. The key thing is understanding the type of scarring and the pathophysiology behind the scarring. Sorry, every time I talk, my mask goes below my nose, it's not intentional. So here, the skin is actually stuck down to the layer of tissue below, and we need to separate that. If we don't separate that, the laser or the needling or whatever is done afterwards wouldn't cut, improving the scarring in any way. So we have to subsize and release the skin first. Once we've done this, the laser can then deal with what we call the intradermal scarring, the scarring within the skin. But the laser isn't magic. It can't get to below the skin and release that. So to do that, what we do is we perform Taylor Liberator subcision. Now, all methods of subcision pale into insignificance when it comes to Taylor Liberator subcision, because Taylor Liberator subcision will completely release this cheek and all the scars from the tissue below. I'm using the tangential lighting to illustrate that a little bit better. And once we've done that, we have a completely free cheek, and then our improvement will already be pretty substantial after the Taylor Liberator subcision alone, let alone doing the laser. In this type of scarring, we can expect to get a minimum of around about 60% improvement with one Taylor Liberator subcision and CO2 fully ablative resurfacing combined. So I'm just going to outline, for example, the area that we're going to subsize. This is the region. When I say full field, I'm not fiddling about with ridiculous techniques like needles or cannulas that can only just basically poke holes here or there. We're going to release the whole cheek, no messing. So there's going to be a small 3mm insertion point here, and the Taylor Liberator, which is a V or W bladed tool, will go right into the medial area, and then we will release this whole amount of scarring here. Nothing can achieve that more completely and more safely than Taylor Liberator subcision. It is the way forward when improving acne scarring that is rolling and tethered. Now, once we've done that, we're going to move on 3 to 4 weeks later to perform a fully ablative laser resurfacing. Fully ablative resurfacing is much, much more potent than fractionated laser resurfacing. Fractionating laser resurfacing has a role, and we add that on to our fully ablative laser resurfacing by literally doing a pass of fractional first, and at much greater depth and density than most people would do a fractional laser when treating acne scarring, just because we do things at a much greater aggressive nature to get the improvement that we require in a short space of time. Then we follow up with passes of fully ablative CO2 laser. In this case, that's what we'll be using. It can also be Erbium YAG, but it depends on the case. So here, that is the plan for this lady. We need to basically chumesse her first. So if we use something like chumescent anesthesia, we don't get too much bleeding with the subcision. Funnily enough, it's a very aggressive subcision, but there's really little bleeding and trauma caused because of the fact that we use tumescent containing adrenaline. Most subcision that's performed is very, very bloody, and no core needle subcision results in a cutting of a lot of perforators and bleeding and bruising because people do not use tumescent anesthesia. So let's get on with this case today. In short, if you're going to have your acne scarring managed properly, come to a center that manages it regularly as their day job, and you'll get things done much more effectively without wasting money. Thank you.